Do we have permission to launch?
Roger. We are confirmed at T-minus 10 seconds and counting. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition. Huh?
Geppetto, look! I'm a real boy!
Matches? What, 7, 8? You shouldn't be playing with these. I think it's time we had a talk.
But
you're probably thinking,
but toys can't move!
And we don't usually move in front of...
Was our ticket home?
Not quite. When I first got here, I read the script and talked with John and made a lot of notes on the film and the characters and what was going on, and then found the two key contrasting sequences, one of which is where Woody pushes Buzz out the window.
Buzz!
One where they reconcile at the end of the film.
Buzz, I can't do this without you. I need your help.
I've kind of worked up a palette for those and talked to John a lot about those. And a lot of his ideas on the color for this film were from like Maxfield Parrish and illustrators like William Joyce and Kevin Hawks and Steve Johnson, children's book illustrators. So, he had a pretty good idea of what he wanted color-wise, and it was a lot of saturated colors, a lot of bounce light, things like that, and our main character's home, because we wanted it to be a safe environment and something that just said warmth, you know. And then we have Sid's house, which is kind of dark, stuck in 1972, which was kind of fun, but, you know. We have paneled walls, really cheap paneled walls, and avocado green sculptured carpet, and rusty beds and barbed wire on the beds and torture devices, you know. And, and a lot of wild angles. But the biggest thing this film does to advance computer animation, I believe, is it tells a story. It tells a very simple story with really developed personalities and relationships. The story led the art direction, the lighting, the music, you know. It challenged the technical crew on this film to things that maybe they didn't think they could do or hadn't thought of before. And then there's a lot of little technical advances on the way. I mean, there's no better way of learning new things and doing new things than just doing them, or having a problem presented that you have to solve, you know, rather than just sitting in a room and saying, well, let's try this or let's try that. You know, what if, oh my God, we designed something in the story that we need to do in a certain way. How do we do it? And there's nothing like challenging it, one of the technical directors, because they could solve anything here. You know, they really can solve anything. But also, one of the things we tried to do with this film was to remove it from its computer look. You know, the thing that computer does easiest is straight lines, and we have our share of straight lines because this is a film with a lot of architecture. But we tried to soften it by rounding the corners slightly here and there, and using a lot of specialized lighting, a lot of bounce light, a lot of very, very careful lighting. We had a really great lighting crew on this film. You know, just planning a palette, planning a color for the entire film. And we didn't really try so much to make everything so realistic and the toys realistic and the humans realistic. What we wanted to do was make it believable, you know, and create an entire world versus trying to create reality. In a lot of ways, we've tried to make it hyper-real, you know, and I don't mean, like, more than real. It's just a kind of a heightened sense of reality. And what we tried to do was a cartoon. It was still a tremendous challenge. And